लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद बैलेंस शीट लाइफ इंश्योरेंस वी आर डूइंग लाइफ इंश्योरेंस अकाउंट वी आर डूइंग बैलेंस शीट नाउ सो इन दिस टू क्वेश्चन वी आस्ट ही विल आस्क इन एग्जाम रेवेन्यू अकाउंट द प्रॉब्लम्स विच वी सॉल्व इन अर्लियर क्लासेस एंड ही विल आस्क बैलेंस शीट ऑल्सो ओके नाउ सी वॉट इज सेज इन बैलेंस शीट द फॉर्मेट ऑफ बैलेंस शीट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इट्स वेरी इजी फर्स्ट वी आर हैविंग सोर्सेस ऑफ फंड्स Then we have long-term borrowings. In sources of funds, we are having shareholders fund, share capital shield number 5, reserves and surplus, we are having shield number 6. Okay. Then this debit, credit, fair changes, we'll see when we solve problem. Then we do subtotal. Then we are having borrowings and we are having policyholders fund. Okay. Then we are having policy liabilities. We are having insurance reserves, provisions for linked liabilities. Okay. Then we do subtotal. Then we have future funds for future appropriations. See, funds from future appropriations we get from the revenue account. The revenue account we prepare from that, we get funds for future appropriation that we have right here. Okay. Funds for future appropriations. So it's very easy. So first we write sources of funds. In that you have to write shareholders fund. First will always come shareholders fund. Share capital you have to write and you have to write reserves and surplus. Then you have to write borrowings. Then you have to write policyholders fund. And you have to write policy liabilities. And you have to write insurance reserves. Provision for linked liabilities we have to write here. We do subtotal, then we do total funds for future appropriation, then we have to do total of 1, 2, 3 totals we have to do. Okay, schedule numbers we are having for share capital 5, reserves and surplus 6 and borrowing 7. Next we are having application of funds. So we have having investments, there is no share, schedule number. So policy shareholders we are having 8, policy holders we are having 8A. This all we have to remember. Then assets held to cover linked liabilities, that is 8B. Then we are having loan 9, fixed assets 10, current assets we are having, under current assets we are having cash and bank balance 11, advances and other assets we are having 12, we have to do subtotal A, then we have to do current liabilities and provisions 13, 14, okay. See, the life insurance we should not write current liabilities here, we have to write current liabilities after the assets. Okay, so we have to write current asset liability here. After assets, we have to write subtotal A. Current liabilities and provisions, we have to write here. Then we have written subtotal. Then we have to write net current assets. How to write net current assets? Total of current assets minus current liabilities. Okay, then we get what? The amount, then miscellaneous expenditure. If it is there in the question, debit balance in profit loss account, we have to deduct. We get total C, that is assets. So schedule numbers we are having for assets is shareholders 8, policyholders 8A. And we are having investments, assets held to cover linked liabilities 8B, loans we are having 9, fixed assets we are having 10, current assets we are having cash and bank balance 11, advance and other assets 12, we are having subtotal, then we have current liabilities 13, provisions 14, then subtotal B, from A we have to deduct B, from net current assets to get net current assets we have to write A minus B, okay, then we have to write debit balance and profit loss, if it is there in the question then you have to do total. It's very easy. So there is no simple, there is no one question in the balance sheet, only on the balance sheet he is asking both questions in the exam, balance sheet and what revenue account he is asking. Okay, so revenue account we have solved. Now we'll do problems on both balance sheet and revenue account. Okay, let us continue the question. Page number F16. In this we have to prepare revenue account and balance sheet also. See what he says here. The under mentioned balances form a part of trial balance of Safe Assurance Company Limited as of 31st March 2004. Okay, so life assurance fund at the beginning of the year that will go to reserves and surplus. Okay, claims by death and claims of maturity, this will go to benefits paid. Revenue account, this we have tried in balance sheet. This do both will go to benefits paid. Premium is a revenue first item. Expenses of commission, this is a revenue profit and loss account, it will go revenue account, it will go expenses of management, commission, expenses of management will go to operating expenses, commission to agents will go to commission, consideration when it is granted is other income, interest on interest, dividends and rent gross, this is what we have tried under other income from investments, and income tax on income, interest and dividends we have tried this in balance sheet. Okay, fines, this is TDS. Fines, we have charged some fines, that fines we have to write under, so it's easy. Fines is been paid or charged, it is charged, it we have to write under this fines under, yes, fines we have to write under other income, right? Okay, then we are having surrenders, we know benefits paid and it is benefits paid, bonus paid in cash, this is important. Okay, bonus paid in cash, we have tried this in benefits paid, bonus and reduction of premium. This is also important. This is 5,000. This is important. We have adjustment related to this. Let me put two dots. Claims outstanding. So claims outstanding, we know what we have to do. This is outstanding. Outstanding means it's a liability. We have to write under current liability. Capital we are having means share capital. We are having 4 lakhs. Loan on mortgage of property. The government securities we have invested 15 lakhs. Loan we have given 5 lakhs. And we have given cash at bank 2 lakh rupees 2000 as a balance. We are having in cash account. Prepare revenue account and balance sheet after taking into consideration the following. So claims by death covered under reinsurance, we are having 12,000. This will be, we are having adjustment. Okay, for the claims by death intimated, we this also adjustment we are having. This will both will go to revenue account and profit balance sheet. We'll see when we do problems. Further reduction in utilization of premium is 3,000. So this is also important. Next we have to write interest accrued is how much? 12,000. And premium outstanding is 8,000. So this is a question, we have to solve it. It's very easy to solve this question. First we'll prepare revenue account format. So in company name of the company is Safe Assurance Company Limited. So we write revenue account. For the year ended, March 31st, 2004. Slowly we'll solve this problem. It's very easy. Okay. So particulars, schedule numbers, and amount we have to write. Okay. So we'll write one after the other. All the items we'll write. First we have to write premium earned. So let us first complete the format. Exam also you have to write first. Complete the format. Premium earned. Then we write income from investments. Okay. Then we write under this interest, dividends and rent gross. Interest, dividends and rent gross. Okay. Then we have to write add accrued here. We'll write up that at the time when we solve the problem. Then we write other income. Under other income we are having one income, that is fines. Okay. Next we write consideration for annuities granted. Annuities granted. Next we are having, after that we do write total A here. We'll write total A here. Then we write commission. Then we write operating expenses. Then we write total B. Then we write benefits paid. Total C. We have to write surplus D, A minus B minus C. Okay. Next, after that we have to prepare balance sheet. Okay, let me prepare the balance sheet format. Now we are preparing balance sheet format now. So we'll write here balance sheet as it. March 31st, 2004. So first we will write sources of funds. Under this we'll write shareholders fund. Then we have to write share capital, reserves and surplus. Then we write borrowings. Then we have to do totals. Then we'll write application of funds. Means application of funds means assets. Under this first one we'll write investments. Then we'll write loans. After that we'll write fixed assets. We write current assets. Then we write cash and bank balance. कैश एंड बैंक बैलेंस. ओके देन वी राइट एडवांसेस. देन वी हैव टू डू टोटल. राइट करंट लाइबिलिटीज. वी राइट टोटल बी. ओके after this field write we have to prepare out that working notes we have to do. So we have prepared working notes, okay, and we have to write for balance sheet all the schedule numbers. So we'll write balance sheet all schedule numbers. Share capital schedule number 5 we are having for share capital, 6 we are having for reserves and surplus, and 7 we are having for borrowings. Then we are having for investments schedule number 8. Loans we are having 9, fixed assets we are having 10, current assets we are having 2, 11 for cash and bank balance, 12 for advances and 13 for current liabilities. Okay, so we have written schedule numbers for share capital 5, reserves and surplus 6, borrowing 7, investments 8, loans 9, 10 fixed assets, and under current assets we are having 2 items. Okay, 1 we are having cash and bank balance 11, advances 12 we are having, and current liabilities we are having 13. So it is starting from first is revenue premium earned, second is a commission, third is operating expenses, fourth is benefits paid. So we are having schedules from 1 to 13. Okay, and we are preparing now working notes. That is schedule number 1 premium we have to write first. Schedule number 1 premium. After that we don't have any other items, so we can prepare one item we are having for other expenses. So we are writing schedule number 4 benefits paid. Okay, after that we have to prepare schedule number reserves and surplus here. Surplus. After that, we are having one more, that is cash, current assets. Then we are having current liabilities. So I have prepared 1, 2 reserves and surplus is 6, current assets is 12, current liabilities 13. Okay. So 1 is premium, 4 is benefits paid, 6 is reserves and surplus, 7 is current assets, and 13 is current liabilities. So we have prepared all the formats and we can solve the problem easily now. Okay, let us start solving the problem. So first item we are having life assurance fund at the beginning of the year, that we have to write under reserves and surplus. So we have prepared reserves and surplus head form working notes. We have to write here life assurance fund. So amount is 14,70,000. Done. After that we are having claims by death, claims by maturity, both we have tried under benefits paid. So we'll go to benefits paid and we'll write claims by death. Claims by death we are having 77,000, and claims by maturity we are having 56,000. Okay. Then we are having premium 2,10,000. So we have tried here premium. Under premium working note 2,10,000. After that we are having expenses of management, that we have tried under operating expenses. So amount is 20,000 expenses of management we are having. So operating expenses 20,000. Then we are having commission to agents, directly we can write 25,000. So that is commission we can write again directly 25,000 under schedule number 2. Then after that we are having consideration for annuities granted, amount is 12,000. So consideration for annuities granted we have to write here under 12,000 under other income. After that we are having income interest tax, interest dividends and rent, gross is 54,000. So we have tried under here income from investments 54,000. Next we are having income tax on interest and income tax on interest and dividends. So it is TDS. How much TDS we are having? 3000. So TDS we have tried under advances. So we have to go to current assets and we have tried TDS. TDS. Okay. How much is that? 3000. After that we are having fines. Fines we have tried under other income 2000. So we have written here other income in revenue account 2000 fines. After that we are having surrenders. We have tried surrenders and annuities. Surrenders and annuities into benefits paid 22000 and 30000. So in working note we have tried under benefits paid. We have prepared a working note. In that we'll write first what we are having here. Surrenders. How much surrenders we are having? 22000. We are having surrenders 22000 and we are having annuities 30000. Annuities 30000. Next we have bonus paid in cash, that is 10000. That also we have tried under benefits paid 10000. Bonus paid in cash, see here 10000. So bonus paid in cash amount is 10000. Next we are having for bonus in reduction of premium is 5000. Bonus in reduction of premium is 5000. So how much we are having for adjustment bonus? Further bonus utilized in reduction of premium is 3000. Okay, so premium already we are having 28 8 2 lakh 10,000 and 8000 outstanding we have to add. Okay, we'll add later. Now here we are having two premiums. Now see, bonus in reduction of premium 1 we are having, again further reduction in bonus of premium is 3000. Okay, so the bonus in reduction of premium, what you have to do? 5000 rupees. This we have to write here. Bonus in reduction of premium we have tried here. We have tried under benefits paid. Bonus in reduction of premium we have tried under benefits paid. So we'll write here in benefits paid. Bonus in reduction of premium. Reduction of premium. We are having how much here? We are having 5000 plus adjustment is how much? 3000. Total 8000. So we have tried 5000 plus 3000, 8000 we are having here. Okay, and this 3000 which we are writing here, this premium we have to add to this, we have to deduct from this premium for the reduction. 3000 from premium 1, schedule number 1, further reduction we have to deduct here 3000. The adjustment 1 we have to deduct. Okay, so the next is what? Our claims outstanding. This is liability. Outstanding means liability. So current liability you have to write. Claims outstanding. Claims outstanding. How much is claim outstanding? 80,000. I'm leaving one line space. One item is there. Then we are having outstanding annuities. So after one line I'm writing outstanding annuities. How much is outstanding annuities? 22,000. Okay, then we are having capital 4 lakhs. Directly we can write into format. So we'll go to the format, we'll write capital. How much capital? 4 lakhs in front of capital. After that we are having government securities 15 lakhs. So that you write under investments 15 lakhs. Okay, after that we are having loans on mortgage of property. That is loans on mortgage means we are giving loan. So there is loans. How much is loans? 5 lakhs. That is application of funds, we are giving loans. Then we have a cash at bank. How much cash at bank we are having? 2000. So directly we can write under current assets here 2000. Okay, instead of writing out a column, writing in a column. So we have done with all these items in the revenue the particulars. Now we have to go for adjustments. Now so first is what? Claims by death covered under reinsurance 12,000. So covered under reinsurance means what? We have to go to benefits paid and we have to deduct first claims by death 12,000 minus, we write minus covered under reinsurance. Covered under reinsurance, how much? 12,000 you have to deduct first effect, and second effect you have to show under advances. Current assets you have to show under current assets, right? Under amount due from other insurers. Amount due from other insurers. How much is that? 12,000. Done. So two adjustments we have done for this. Next we have claims, further claims admitted by death, 10,000. So further claims means what? We have one liability and one we have to deduct. Add further claims. Further claims admitted. How much is that further claims? 10,000. And we have tried here plus further added. Further. How much? 10,000. Done. This is also done. Now bonus introduction of premium we have already done. 3,000 we have deducted from premium and we have done that. Interest accrued is 12,000. So interest accrued 2,000. Two effects we have tried. First we have tried under advances. So right under advances, interest accrued. First effect, amount is 12,000. Second effect, interest accrued, we have to go to the here, interest, dividends and rent. To that we have to add accrued 12,000. Okay, so to interest outstanding we have to add, and we have interest that we have to write as what, where here in the advances, current assets. Current assets, this is advances head. Current assets, we are having two heads. One is cash at bank, one is advances, and that advances we have tried. Last one is what? Premium outstanding is 8,000. So premium outstanding we have tried two places. At first we'll write here plus outstanding premium, amount is 8,000 rupees. First effect. Second effect we have tried under advances outstanding premium. 8,000. Done. So we have written all this information which is given in the question. Now we have to close one item the other. First we'll quote the close the revenue account first. So we are having two items written of revenue account. One is premium, other is what, benefits paid. So 2,18,000 minus 3,000. 2,18,000 minus 3,000. We get 2,15,000 as a premium. Okay. So we get 2,00,000. At 10 plus 8. Further reduction of premium we have to deduct. Nah. Okay, that we have to add. Sorry, no. We have to add further reduction. It's 2,21,000. Further, we have to add this further reduction of bonus premium. So we get 2,21,000 here. So right under, in front of premium, 2,21,000. Further reduction means you have to add to the premium. Okay. Next, after that, what we have to close? We have to close benefits paid. So benefits paid, we have to close 77,000 plus 56,000, 22,000, 30, 10, 8, 10 minus 12,000. So we're doing 2,01,000 as benefits paid. So you can easily write this under benefits, in front of benefits paid, 2,01,000. Okay, so we have closed this. So now we can easily close revenue account. So revenue account, we are having 2,21,000 plus 54,000 plus 12,000 plus 2,000 plus 12,000. So we're getting 3,01,000 as our total of income. 3,01,000 as total of income. Okay, next we have to add this 25,000 plus 20,000. We will get 45,000 here as this total B, and total C is 2,01,000. So from okay, 3,01,000, if you deduct 45,000 and if you deduct 2,01,000, you get 55,000 as surplus. Balance carried forward to, yes, surplus we are getting 55,000. Okay, this surplus we have to add to this here. Two reasons in surplus, so 55,000. Okay, so this is surplus we got from revenue account. So 14,70,000 plus 55,000, if you add, you get 15,25,000. Reserves and surplus. So you come here and write reserves and surplus 15,25,000. Okay. So next you close current assets. 3,000, 12,000, 8,000. You get 35,000 as total of current assets. Let me cross check the total of current assets. 3,000 plus 12,000 plus 12,000 plus 8,000. 35,000 is total of current assets. So this 35,000 you have to write here. Advance is 35,000. Total is 37,000. Current liabilities you have to do total now. 80 plus 10, 90, 90 plus 22. 1,12,000 you have to write here. And you have to write here 1,12,000. Okay. 1,12,000 minus 37,000. You get 75,000 negative balance. So here you have to write 75,000 negative. Okay. Now we can close easily. 15 plus 5, 20 lakhs. Now to close the balance sheet now. So first we'll check here. 4 lakhs plus 15, 25. So we get total as 19,25,000. It's easy, right? 19,25,000. Here also 20 lakhs minus 75,000. We get 19,25,000. See why I'm deducting means, see your advances is 37,000. The liabilities is more, 1,27,12,000. Your advances, your cash and bank balance 2,000, advances is 35,000. Total is 37,000. So your assets is 37,000, liabilities is 1,12,000 current liabilities. So you have to get, when you deduct, you get negative answer. So 75,000 you have to deduct from this fixed assets. Okay. So it's like, it's very easy like this. You have to solve the problems.